Yeah, you can choose whether you want to go like the damage dealing route, or you want to go the spell amp route. Like phase shift attack, the 30 damage talent, level 10 and 15 is like extremely good. Like whatever you choose to go for, like it always feels like a good option. This is what I like about the hero.
I think again we're gonna see DJ go more into the natural order than we saw the Elder Titan yesterday.
Oh, for sure. Like the
16-2 leads the CS, doing a great job. Over towards top, we take a look. Zephyr going after this Legion commander. Jab's just trying to push him back as best he can with the Skywrath mage now picking point in that arcane bolt.
Surprise, Legion Commander does not have a point in press the attack. I think in this type of lane, you get 1 point in passive, and then you get like 1 or 2 points in press the attack, just to be able to like dispel things, like dispel the stun against the Phoenix is extremely good.
Top of the CS. Very contested pick in the puff, kind of struggling a bit over in the mid lane.
DJ bottom, dropping very low, but there's the sell.
I know Cuckoo's under the tower, but no rotations coming in from Fnatic just yet.
Dire are scary.
Do have the Phoenix.
Pot the coil on mid.
There's the coil of Thrukan spam against Silence. They first dive over. They brought in the Skywrath Mage, so Jab's trying to help out his mid. Keep Moon alive.
I was about to say that I love the build on Moon. Like you need to get it, finish it. But sometimes you really don't. Like it's not that cheap as it seems.
Zephyr in trouble, goes to the Icarus dive. Arcane Bolt coming his way. Does have that stick to pop, but Mazaros doesn't want to give up on this kill.
Item. It got buffed in the previous match. I don't feel it's really not that great. Mid lane.
Trouble.
Do not fix broken things.
The 5 position Elder Titan, so critical team fight ended just for the Elder Titan. Now the rotation's coming in from Fnatic. The Jab's already sitting low. They got the Wukong's Gang. Carl will drop here. Sunray's not going to be on top of him to save him. He's really not doing much to move. He sits back on the Wukong's, but he's still a 4 heroes right by the tower ready to go. They drop the Supernova that can have a little longer to take on turns just once. Supernova is used. Fnatic don't want to chase this. They found the Banshee Echo, hit the Ramp King, find themselves to great sweep hitting onto the Banshee that sets up the duel. Earth's going to max
out that Echo Stomp and probably just be max out more after that.
Just like your ship.
Slowly using that new pro, it's going to probably hold on to Jabs. Pushed up on. Twaymon will grab the kill on the Skywrath Mage, Mazaros. About going in, he's got Raven right here. The duel moves on a car who's coming to drill the coil. They get the kill on time as they can. More dual damage going the way. The Legion Commander, the Rolling Thunder comes in from Cuckoo. Not landing, swinging the seams of the Radiant side. Now on back towards the tower. Again, Fnatic, they're always looking for this counter initiation. That's just how they played the mid fight. You come in with the Dream Coil and it doesn't do much for you on T1. Well, Fnatic are going to make you pay, and they've already done so twice. With
I wouldn't say like the problem is Pocky getting coil. Witchblade is up. Let's see which route Radiant he takes. 30 damage talent. Okay, so we know what he wants to do.
Deal as much damage as possible. I go to find Jackie. Spot this Raid King, and there's the duel. The square right on top. Winner, winner, chicken dinner now with 50 damage. He brought down the Wukong. They tried to kill off Jackie a second time and are successful. Just a little bit late with the Rolling Thunder.
Still wouldn't make a difference. Is really, really strong. Keep fighting with Io. I like what I see. The item build, Jabs.
Trouble, Sunray on top. And he'll burn out. Elder Titan looking next. Supernova on the back lines of this. Balance strike on the corner. They just don't have the control for the moment. They get the one Zephyr. They're going to take out one. Area out racing out of the fight. Cuckoo trying to man fight as he'll finish him off. Raven losing the one of those goals. But now they've got duel again. But the victory is there for Wyvern. Thanks for the 20 damage. We'll still chase. Try to kill this Enchantress. Finishes him off with a balanced strike. And now it's Carl v. Moon on a 1v1. Although Jackie might have something to say about this. Without Jackie involved. He was killed earlier as they found him twice bottom. Tough for
Dire's middle tower is under pressure.
They have it now this time. Win one duel against me, shame on you, or shame on me, I forget how the saying goes. Either way, there's more duel damage.
Shame on whoever loses the duel, I think.
That's won't be getting 20 from me anymore, especially when we've got Mystic Quare available. They're still looking to pressure the Tier 1 tower. Tier 1 looking to defend, they come in. Everybody but the Enchantress, who's up in 8.
Felt the influence of the Wraith King, like his power in this game. He's involved in only one kill. That's the kill from the laning stage. Sonus is a good target to eliminate.
Masaro's still trying to get the Legion Commander, and I think once they saw that, they started to back up on Fnatic, except for Moon. I think some right clicks, gets low, just able to TP out.
Legion Commander really needs to be careful about the positioning, because if they
be a difference maker. Some of these supernovas that have died have been pretty close, especially the one on top. That one had an extra hit or two, would have definitely gone off. Moon just about to finish the Desolator. I think Battle Strike comes through, but Wayne Grand Silences up the Monkey King. Go for this swashbuckle. After side BKB can pop by Moon, they have the rolling cover coming through from Cuckoo. They also drop down the Dream Coil. Moon TP's away. Jabs, and they have themselves a Wraithfire Blast with Rolling Thunder bouncing up into the air and eventually finishing him off. So Jackie with the kill. First kill again.
Yep. Penguin here picking out to straight up go into Roche Pit against the Elder Titan. Because, yeah, this is what's gonna happen. But Ice Frog says, you know, I'll bless this team with casual double damage on Wraith King.
This is way easier. Boundless Strike, White Bun getting blown up. Supernova, and well, now they have to retreat. Let's see if Fnatic go in for this. They've got this duel, they'll drop the Mystic Quare right down on the Cuckoo. They get the kill to the Pangolier, the Icarus dive away. Carl and Jackie trying to fight the Legion Commander. They've got the Silence with the Wayne Grip, they'll finish off Masaru's. But now Jackie is in a bad position. The double damage is about to fall out. Why can't I lose this first slide? Going on DJ, the damage is too much. The BKB being popped by Moon, I'll go for the second one. The silence to have the damage all getting away, but just not doing enough to save this Wraith King. Dream Coil plays down, Rolling Thunder coming in and from Cuckoo, who bought back the Snap It, even keeping Moon at a decent level of health. Now they'll try to turn this Guitar Raven Sunray right on top of the two of them. Moon burning down low, Infinite Shines coming in, Whitemon takes him out.
Whitemon kills the Moon, but a couple of buybacks expended on both sides. Like, Puck is just food.
Long way until he gets under attack. It's that BKB, though. Sword floor.
Dire's top tower is about to take the plunge.
Two significant items getting closer to that level 3 on the Supernova. We'll see, again, adding hits needed. Might and be the difference maker in these
now
fights.
That I'm thinking about it, like, Heart on Io makes so much sense because it doesn't have this out of combat. Like, you have the constant region of Heart effect.
Headband. Now who's taking that?
Have a way of pushing enemies away from you, and cast range is really nice. Also, extra hit.
Splash button coming in from the Battle Strike. Taking on a Death Rock. Maybe they have the Super Pit in. Now the Super Pit looks like he's gonna lose that one. Jackie's got himself some damage. No Supernova at Pops. And now the Dream Coil to follow it up. This fight going pretty well for T1 for the morning. Oh,
said that they need to reset their BKB timing. Ground. Here it comes.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Monkeys out in 50. Don't think they'll try to go for another high ground. This Fnatic should just, you know, hold the high ground moon in a bit of a trouble.
Really close to grabbing that kill onto the Raven King. That was fantastic.
Now, Fnatic was playing so well first. 25
Radiant's
minutes
top
of the
tower. Radiant's middle tower can't handle this damage.
Any shard that you think is of value in this game?
They lost the three heroes.
Jackie
needs to win the ball back.
Good for TY, and this is about a 20,000 network shift.
Nice middle
finish for a BK.
Ace is gone. Jackie's still dead. Might need to be
sure what they can get out of this.
Monkeys, he still wants to fight. BKB plus Wukong's command is up.
And Cole comes in with a 2-1 lane grip. They've got the green claw to Raven as well as Moon. But this seems more like a disengage than anything. T1 will go back to their high ground and try to defend potentially one last time.
This is it. They only have one more fight. If they lose this fight, the game just ends.
See what they can do with this. T1.
But yeah. In the end, they make it work like this.
Good on zombie apocalypse.